Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel Learn Web Coding. My name is Durgesh Sahani and we are creating series of video tutorials for GCP. So in the previous session we have seen how to create buckets on Google Cloud Storage from console. Now in this session I'm going to show you how to set up a Cloud Storage PHP library, and by using that library we will perform all the buckets related operations like creating bucket, listing bucket, deleting, uploading files and all. So all those operations we are going to see by using this library. So let's go to the cloud.google.com, and from here they have given the steps how we can actually implement it. So go to the products and then select for cloud storage. From here you can read more about it, and but I want you to go to the documentation section. And from here you will find a quick start tutorial for using console. That's what we have seen in the previous video, using JS util tool or using APIs and libraries. So click on this link, view libraries, and here you can see all these supported programming languages are here, and by using any of this you can perform all those operations. So as I'm going to show you for PHP, so I'm going to copy this, and by using Composer we can install this library in our working directory. So as you can see, our working directory is this. So you can just simply open your bash or maybe any window terminal and hit enter. So it will start downloading that this library over here. Till the time it is downloading, let's go ahead and see what extra we things we need to do. So first thing is go to the create a service account key, and that you can do by going to this link and create a service account, new service account, and then give any name, then role. Under role you have to select project and owner, and after that create a JSON file will get created. That is what you need to authenticate. So go here and click on this new service account and name it storage account. Okay, storage account. Under role select project owner. So storage account name we have given, and this is what your account ID going to be. Now select this JSON and click on create. So it will create a JSON file. That is what we need. Okay, so it's created. Now I'm just going to under downloads, and here the file is. Copy it. Now go to the our directory, and here I'm going to create a new directory called credentials. Let's put it into it, and after that see the next thing is what they have mentioned. Once you are done with this, then on Windows machine you have to set a path, environment path variable, so that it will take this credential file from there, read it from there, and start performing whatever you have given the command. So this is the code they have given to create a bucket. So let's see whether it is working for us. And this part I'm going to show you from code only how you can do that. So just copy this the name, copy this name, and there is a method in PHP. Let's say open PHP. Oops. Question mark PHP. Oops. Put environment, and here you have to say this is the environment variable we want to set equal to the credential file path. So copy its path, you need absolute path, and assign it over here. Sometime it as you can see slash t is used for escape, so for tab, so it get escape. So that's why I ask you to at every backward slash make it twice, so that it won't break or it won't escape any character. Now we are done with this second part. Next is we have to copy the code for doing this creating a bucket. So just copy this. You can also set it into environment variable, but I'm going to use this method. I'll paste this. Okay, so we are including this vendor directory and I think it is downloaded now. Let's see. Oops. So here you can see vendor directory and here is the autoload file. So this is what it want. So autoload file, it get loaded, and then we are creating object of this class, and then specify your project ID, and for me it is learn web coding. Then we are creating object of this class storage client and passing this project ID. Then what name you want to give while creating a bucket. So let's say I'm going to give this name, and then this is the actual method which is going to create bucket, and once it is created it will print the bucket name. Simple. Now save this file and go to your browser and refresh this. Line number 32. Oh, I think semicolon we have missed here. Yep. Now done. Save this file, refresh this page, and I think it should create a bucket for you. Here you can see bucket Durgesh created. Now go to your cloud GCP and go to the storage and check whether that bucket is created or not. And yes, here you go. This bucket is created. Now if you want to create one more, you have to just name it and refresh this. And it is created. Just refresh this. Here you go. Right? So see how simple it is to by using this library you can create a bucket. Now if you want to list those buckets, so I'm going to let's create a class now. PHP class, name it storage or whatever you want, and here I'm going to say public function create a create bucket, and within it let's paste it. Oops. Cut it again, paste it here, and these two things we want to do at the top, and this line should be under constructor because every time it should so I'm going to create one constructor and let's paste it here. So every time when once we create an instance of this class, it will get called and it will put it into environment variable. And again, we want this name should be at, I guess, all these things over here. Here, and make a variable private project ID, and you can use here this project ID is equal to we have assigned, and the same you can pass it to here. After that, now let's create one more private variable here, storage, and similarly here as well. So we are making a method so that whenever we need, we can simply call these methods. Remove this as well. So bucket name, just we have to pass bucket name and we are done. So let's try now. If you want to call this method now, just we have to do here is include that class. File name is storage. PHP and create object of storage class like this. And on dollar storage, create bucket and pass the bucket name. So now simply once we do this and refresh this web page, you can see the bucket is created. If you go here and refresh, you can see our bucket is created. How simple it is, right? So what I did here is I just wanted to make sure everything is in a good way so that you can see. Now next time what we want to create a new next function to list all the buckets, so we will add those functions over here. So I'll give you one more example for listing all the buckets. So here you can say public function get all buckets, or let's say simply list buckets. So see, you have this object, and if you want to read more about all these methods, so here is the link for all API references and cloud storage API references. Client library explained. I guess here the link is where they have explained each and every methods. Oh, sorry, I was missing. So on PHP references, here you can go and you will find a depth how you can use these libraries and what are the parameters you can pass, how to even the code, how to create object of the bucket by selected object, or even if you want to list all the buckets. So see, here is the link. This is what we need to use. And instead of this, you can pass this one. Once it will be done, then simply echo in loop and it will list all the buckets for you. Refresh this. Now call these methods over here and remove these parameters. And we can comment it out for some time being. Now see whether it is listing all these three buckets. Here you can see Durgesh, Sahani and Sahani. So all these three buckets, it is listing what we have over here. So that's all about this, guys, how to set up this client library for accessing GCP buckets. Now in the next session, I'll show you how to add some more method here, like deleting buckets or uploading files, uploading, editing files, deleting files, all those things, how we can do it. I'll cover it into the next video. So thanks very much guys for watching. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, and thanks again for watching.